What are atoms, molecules, and compounds? If you shred a big watermelon with a very sharp samurai to be divided in half, smaller and smaller pieces until it can't be broken down anymore, these smallest parts are called elements. The fundamental unit of an element is atom. Each element contains only one type of atom. Noble gases such as helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon are elements that exist as individual atoms, which is why they are called monoatomic elements. What are molecules? Unlike the elements that have only one type of atom, molecules are formed by two or more atoms that are chemically combined. Molecules can be diatomic or polyatomic. Diatomic meaning that the molecules are formed by the combination of two atoms. For example, a hydrogen molecule is formed by two hydrogen atoms chemically combined. This is how the hydrogen molecule is found in nature and can be denoted as H2. Polyatomic meaning that the molecules are formed by the combination of three or more atoms. For example, an ozone molecule is formed by the combination of three oxygen atoms. This is how the ozone molecule is found in nature and can be denoted as O3. What are compounds? Remember how molecules are two or more atoms that combine together? Compounds are also a molecule, but those elements must be different. For example, water is a compound. It is made by chemically joining an oxygen atom with two hydrogen atoms. The ratio of hydrogen atoms to oxygen atoms in water is 2:1. Changing this ratio will give us a different compound. Composition of a compound. When we take a look at the periodic table, we can find all of the elements that make up the compound can be classified as metal and non-metal elements. The right side of the line are non-metals, and the other side are metals, except hydrogen. If metal elements are present to form a compound, it is called an ion compound. Meanwhile, if the compounds are only formed between non-metallic elements, they are called molecular or covalent compounds. Properties of a compound. You may think that since compounds are made of elements combined together, therefore, compounds will have the same property as that of the elements that make it, right? The fascinating thing is that this is not the case. A compound has different properties from the elements that form it. An example of this is that magnesium is a type of metal that burns in oxygen to form a compound called magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide has different properties than both magnesium and oxygen. Magnesium is a solid with a silvery appearance. Oxygen, as we all know, is a colorless gas. However, magnesium oxide is a white solid. Naming compound. Naming compounds are relatively straightforward. For example, carbon and oxygen combine to form carbon dioxide. Sodium and chlorine chemically combine to make sodium chloride. And zinc and oxygen form zinc oxide. Chemical formula of a compound. A chemical formula tells us the types of elements present in a compound and the ratio of different atoms present in a compound. For example, H2O, the H and O tell us the kinds of elements present, and 2 tells us that there are two hydrogen atoms. Oxygen has nothing written with it. This means that only one oxygen atom is present.